morning, students. We are going to discuss Kerchhoff's first law. This is also known as junction rule. Junction rule. Or in short, Kerchhoff current law, KCL. According to this law, current entering at the junction are equal to current leaving at the junction. Suppose though we have a current, this is the junction, and current are coming, suppose I1 current is coming and I2 current is coming on that junction, and third one current is going from junction I3 and I4 are going from junction. So according to this rule, the current coming, the sum of the currents coming from the junction must be equal to the current leaving the junction. There is no loss of current, no loss of charge. Okay, so current entering at the junction I1 plus I2 must be equal to the sum of currents leaving the junction I3 plus I4. A junction rule is being followed for the junction where three or more wires are coming, three or more currents are coming, where there are three or more conductors or wires are there, we will use the junction rule. Okay, when there are four wires, 1, 2, 3, 4, two wires are coming and two is going. Okay, that's why it can also be written that the sum of currents at the junction will be zero. Sum of currents, suppose we will all add together, it will become minus 3, minus 4, equal to 0. Sum of currents leaving and entering will be equal to 0. There is no loss of charges. It also based on the conservation of charge. This law is based on conservation of charges. Conservation of charge. The charge coming, what is charge? Current is flowing charge per second. Flowing charge per second entering is equal to the charge leaving. There is a conservation of charge. Okay. Now we will do a question based on this. Suppose we have a current. Here are 4 ampere current is flowing, and there are 3 ampere current is flowing, and they are entering and they are leaving. 4 ampere current is leaving. We have to find out the current over here. How much current is flowing in this wire? So we apply the law. We apply the law of first law of Kerchhoff. Current entering at a junction must be equal to the current leaving the junction. So current entering at the junction 3 ampere plus 4 ampere must be equal to the current leaving the junction. 4 ampere is leaving plus I. So we can find out the I. Yes, 7 ampere equal to 4 ampere plus I. Therefore I equal to 7 ampere minus 4 ampere equal to 3 ampere. So there is 3 ampere current. So now we can further check out conservation of charges. Current entering into the junction 3 plus 4, 7, 3 plus 4 must be equal to 4 plus 3. Current leaving the junction 4 plus 3. Okay, in this way we can find out the unknown current flowing the junction. Thank you. Have a nice day.